My name is NovaMage. And because I am doing a B-log, I have automatically acquired the power to teleport around my room, like this. I always wanted to do that.
Hello there, people. This thing is NovaMage. Yes, I know. all right. Calm down. You all of you, yes, please. You can sit. It's all right. And you can stop screaming, okay? You know, every time that I have seen a YouTuber, like a face cam or anything, the first thing that crosses through my mind is always like the same thing. Like, for some reason, I don't know what I was expecting, but I'm always surprised. It's like, I don't know, it's like after you have such a long time of hearing the voice of a person and then all of a sudden you get an image. It's like previously you had an image already and for some reason you're surprised. But I don't know with you guys, but with me it's always like I don't know what I was expecting. It's like, okay, I am surprised, but surprised of what? I guess you all know the purpose of this video, which is... Wait a second, what was the purpose of... Oh, wait a second, okay, yeah, I remember. So the purpose of this video is to that I want to thank all of you, and when I say all of you, I really mean all of you, for watching my content, and it's been a really long ride. I mean, it's been really fun doing all this things. I honestly never thought from the beginning, or maybe I did, but I never really thought about, you know, like getting like many subscribers and stuff like that, or I didn't think that I would actually get somewhere. Like there were a lot of times that I thought like, no, I'm just gonna stop this, I'm not going anywhere, and nobody's, I don't know, I like nobody's enjoying this or that. But you know, even though I got tired at some points, I always thought about the fun times, you know, that I have with you guys. So I kept coming back, and you guys kept coming back, and here we are. But I would just want to say I'm really thankful. I never felt like I was gonna achieve something, I guess. And you guys are damn awesome for actually, you know, supporting me and everything. Okay, now, so we do have something else to talk about, and the other reason why we're here is that we have a Q&A to answer, and you guys posted your questions, and now I'm going to answer them. But because you guys overly enjoy watching me kill people as I am talking with you, and that is a proven thing, I'm going to put myself in this corner, maybe like here, like this, yeah, okay, there, that works. And I'm going to be answering your questions while the gameplay rolls in the background, right? Okay, so the first question that we have is from Somebody Gamer, and he says, are you going to make a series of Assassin's Creed 4 once it comes out? Yes, I will. Actually, I made a mistake with that question because I actually answered it in a comment. I guess I wasn't used to doing a Q&A. But yeah, I'm actually going to make Assassin's Creed 4 series once it comes out. I think I will be mostly playing it on the PlayStation 4, though I will also have it on Xbox 360. And like I did with AC3, I'm also going to post my first two games, meaning that I will record my live game, you know, with all my randomness and everything. And I'm going to post it for you guys, regardless of whether I win or lose. So be looking forward to that. Next up is another friendly gamer, and he actually has a ton of questions. This is not just one question, but let's start. Okay, so the first question is, who are your favorite YouTubers? Well, actually, it's not quite like I have a favorite YouTuber. It's more like I have a group of favorite YouTubers, and it's like by categories, I would say. But basically, I have just like two categories, and it's that I have YouTubers that I watch for fun, just because their videos are like funny, and others that I watch mostly for the gameplay, like even though they don't talk or everything.
And the winner for funniest Assassin's Creed YouTuber of the year goes to... It's Kid!
Kid It Tries is unquestionably the funniest YouTuber I have watched. It's, I mean, her, just another day on Assassin's Creed multiplayer video, I have watched it like 4 times, and it's funny because by the 4th time I tried to mark it as favorite for the 2nd time. So yeah, honestly, that video, I enjoyed it. It has to be the funniest video I've ever seen. And also, another thing is that Kid is probably one of the few YouTubers that I actually found on YouTube randomly. I mean, it's not like nobody like told me to watch it or anything. I just found her at random, and I watched one of her videos, and I was like, holy, this is so much fun. Some of the elements of my own style are from Kid, just like the kids. Yeah, those kids. You know those kids. Yeah, those kids are actually an idea of Killed It Tries, and I actually brought them over here because she just didn't want to hear them yelling all the time. Next question. Will you rather fight a bear or a lion? Well, a bear is bigger and slower and stronger. And the lion is strong but is much faster. So actually, I'm not considering fighting either of them. What I'm considering is running away, and given that condition, what I'm going to do is choose the bear. Oh, the bear, you know, like the Assassin's Creed multiplayer. No, I mean an actual bear. Yeah, like, I'll just run the hell out of there. Would you rather play Deathmatch without these guys or firecrackers? Well, honestly, I'll probably still play it, but I'm pretty sure it will be much less funnier. I mean, okay, it's a game about stealth, and there's like zero stealth. It will be a little hard, you know, to get closer to people, because the problem of Deathmatch is that with only one person and without these guys, it just means it's just gonna be like an ability fest out there. So I'll probably still play it, but it will be much more boring. Which of the many holidays is my favorite? All of them. As long as I don't have to work, it is the best day of my life. Next question is, Pepsi or Coca-Cola? Come on, friendly, you don't ask that kind of question. That is too personal. Have you had a poutine? Would you like to have one? I'll be honest, this is the first time I've actually even heard the word. I don't even know if you say it like that. But I don't know. It's a Canadian dish, so I have to be wary of that. Hamburger or pizza? Hamburger. That's out of the question. I mean, pizza is good. It's good, but I'm sorry. I just happen to be a hamburger lover. Mario or Luigi? Of course Luigi. Not if the Nintendo characters are called the Mario Brothers. Would that mean that Mario's name is Mario Mario? Well, actually, I think, and this is just my personal theory, I think that Luigi wasn't meant to exist. Mario was the only one that was meant to exist. So basically, they just said Mario Bros, because actually, like, if you made a two-player game of Mario, it will be just like two Marios. Not Mario and Luigi, you know? Like, it will be like Mario, 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 everywhere. So it would be the Mario Bros, because everybody would be Mario, if you know what I mean. So Luigi is just a byproduct of somebody's imagination. That's just my personal theory, though. Okay, next questions are from Carlos Almeida. Actually, I speak Spanish, so I could have said that with a Spanish accent. But nonetheless, his first question is, will you do a B-lock? Actually, I think that question just got answered on its own, right? How did you start playing Assassin's Creed? Well, you would think it was something actually legendary, but no, it wasn't. It was just a normal day. I happened to go into an arcade, sort of arcade kind of thing, where you have like PlayStations and stuff like that. And I saw somebody playing Assassin's Creed, like climbing buildings and stuff. And I saw that. I wasn't even there for anything like that. I was looking for Devil May Cry games, and I saw that, and I was like, "Whoa, that actually looks pretty cool." Yeah, so I started playing Assassin's Creed 1, and then 2, and so on. That's how I got into the series. Favorite Assassin's Creed until now? Well, first of all, after Brotherhood came out, I became mostly a multiplayer type of guy. I mean, the previous one, you know, there was no multiplayer. I stopped playing so much single player as I did before. And I actually fell in love with Assassin's Creed multiplayer. I could say it's like, well, I mean, it's obvious, isn't it? It's like my biggest passion in terms of video games and that. I don't know, after Brotherhood, Brotherhood was really good, but I was kind of unhappy about certain things in terms of the mechanics of the game, just a little, you know. At least I can say that the game was glitchy, because it wasn't, but I wasn't completely happy with like the way the game was. And then Revelations came out. It did some changes that I liked, but it was too unbalanced in terms of the power of the abilities and that. And now we have 3, which is I like other stuff that they introduced, like killing with the same button and stuff like that. But then Assassin's Creed 3 was incredibly glitchy, and I couldn't say like it was my favorite game of the 3. You know, I've always been left like wanting something else. I don't know if maybe I'm a little too ambitious. But, well, I guess I could say Assassin's Creed Revelations before patch 104 was probably my favorite game so far. Okay, next up is Pirishi Matthew, and his first question is, what is your credit card number? Okay, well, since you asked, I am going to answer you. My credit card number is... and that is my credit card number. I hope you wrote it down, because it's not like I'll be repeating it again, okay? From which country do you come from? The lovely island of Dominican Republic. Yeah, and I'm still here, so actually, if you can manage to hitch a ride over here, just, you know, be sure to come over and say hi. Actually, it's gonna be pretty funny, because in Assassin's Creed 4, there's gonna be like an adventure in the Caribbean. And at least that we have seen, they're gonna be in Cuba, which is a neighboring island to my island. And so I hope maybe we'll see somewhere some adventures in Assassin's Creed in the Dominican Republic. That would be cool. I will say like, hey, I live there. I recognize that place. I have seen that tree, and that kind of stuff. What's your real name? Angel. That's my real name, Unveiled. Oh my god, that's such an uncommon name, isn't it? Why NovaMage? Well, NovaMage actually kind of has like a story to it. Well, you know, it could have been one of those random things, but it actually isn't. Well, Nova, the mage part of NovaMage, is actually, in Spanish, is Mago. And this is a nickname I earned during my university time. To make the long story short, I'm just gonna say that there was a teacher who was asking a question who he thought nobody would answer, and I answered it. So he started calling me, oh, this guy is a mage. He knows everything. And I'm like, what? So it kind of stuck, and yeah, it kind of, people, even like my friends from university, they keep calling me like that even after we came out from university. As for the Nova part, well, that actually is something I chose. Basically, one of the most interesting phenomena that I've always watched in nature is a supernova, which is basically exploding star. So yeah, I don't know, I kind of like that. And nova also means new in Latin, but yeah, that wasn't why I chose that, just because of the star part. And it's, you know, because of the glow. So basically that's it. Next up, we have Balderon 10, and he has two questions. First question is, what do you want to be remembered for? Well, I don't know if overall I want to be remembered for something, but if I was remembered for something, it doesn't have to be like something big. I mean, it doesn't have to be like I discovered the cure of AIDS or something like that. But, well, actually, I never really thought about being remembered for something. And actually, I'm going to join this with your next question, which is, what are your goals in life? Basically, the way I live my life is not in a way that I'm looking to, you know, change the world as a whole. I mean, I do want to, but the best way I think to change the world is by changing the small place where you live. It's like, usually it isn't within your power to change like huge things. So what I've set as my goal for life is basically I just want to do what I think is right, and I want to have fun while doing it, and I want that the people who are around me have fun as well. Basically, that's all I am trying to do. Honestly, I always thought that there's just no point in spending your whole life trying to get money or power in any way, and what happened with your life? I mean, you just wasted all that time, and then you're gonna enjoy it at the end of it. You're gonna do something. So yeah, I never really thought about it that way. I just thought, be happy every day and try to have fun while other people have fun as well. Next question is from Assassin11094, and he says, Xbox One or PS4? Okay, I won't laugh, but I'll say, yeah, PS4. But I already laughed. Pixelmon Khan says, favorite film? Well, Inception. And I'm not saying it is the best movie. This is just personal preference. It was a really new concept, or at least I hadn't seen anything quite like it during my whole life. And I am a writer myself, so I like sources for inspiration. Like, I like seeing new things, and I really like that movie. Saccharin says, would you rather fight 100 duck-sized horses or one horse-sized duck? Well, I guess in this case I'm gonna go with the one horse-sized duck, and I think it's just a rough guess, but I think if you put 100 duck-sized horses together, they're still bigger than one horse-sized duck, right? I mean, if you take 100 normal ducks and you compare it to a horse, they're still bigger, right? Yeah. Besides, there's also the thing that, like with Friendly Gamer, I wouldn't really consider fighting. I mean, I'm just considering running away. So I think it's a lot easier to run away from just one big thing than from 100 small things. Malika says, Nova! Yeah, I know that's how she said it. How many conversations go in your head in a day? Even I don't know. I haven't really stopped to count them. Why must you be so good at this game? Mali, I'm not all that good. It's just that you don't play me enough to beat me. That is all there is to it. Is there any other multiplayer that you're good at? Well, decent. In Uncharted 3 multiplayer, I wouldn't say that I'm a pro. I'm more like an average player. And even in Assassin's Creed, I wouldn't say like I am at the top. I am good, but I don't really dedicate the amount of time that, you know, to be like MLG, I guess. if Assassin's Creed was MLG. Do you have any superpowers? Well, you know, there is a common trend in animes these days, which is that there is always like an anime where everybody has some kind of superpower, and there is always like one with the power of fire, water, etc. And there is always one guy who has like a completely useless superpower. If I had some kind of power, probably one of those useless powers. Yeah, probably the power of never giving up, I guess, or something like that. Yeah, it will surely be something silly. Okay, so Aridus67 says, do you plan to upload footage of any of the upcoming multiplayer games? Well, for Assassin's Creed 4, I will, that's guaranteed. I don't know if maybe for some of the other ones, if there is an Uncharted 4, then I will very likely upload from that game as well. Is the Spanish gameplay applicable in any game to win? Short answer, no. I mean, winning and styling are kind of like opposite concepts to some extent. Usually styling requires some sacrifice, and you're usually going to be at a disadvantage because you're gonna be doing things to make them look fancy, and that requires some effort. Are there any other languages you want to learn? Well, yeah, I would like to learn at least French and Japanese, though I'm sure that Japanese isn't gonna be an easy one. And why? Well, there are some good people I want to visit, and they live in, well, at least that's for French, they live in countries that speak French. And as for Japanese, well, it's just because it's awesome, and because anime is in Japanese, so it will be really cool, like, to hear it on its original language, like with the expressions and everything. Any advice in case of a zombie attack? Well, actually, this question has been asked also by Rudonian besides Aridus67, so the answer goes for both of you. Number one, run. Running is always a better strategy than fighting the zombies. If you stay in the same spot, you're gonna get surrounded and you're gonna die. Number two, aim for the head. No questioning about that. Number three, if you need to hide from the zombies, then the perfect place for that is the Raccoon City Police Department, as that place has a history of being one of the best safe havens against the zombies. Not number four. If for some reason somebody says, oh, let's split our group so we can cover more ground, hit them with a hammer or something. That is the most stupid idea that somebody can come up with. If you get split, somebody's gonna get bitten, and when you regroup, that person is gonna transform and bite everybody else. So the best thing you can possibly do is that if you're traveling in a group, just stay with that group and never get split. Although on the other hand, if somebody does get bitten, then you're all gonna die anyway. Number five, this one's kinda related to the previous one, but you want to be constantly checking everybody in your group, just in case somebody got bitten and they're not telling anyone else, but they are staying in the group, because yeah, there is always one son of a, yes, that is always bitten and he stays in the group. And nobody notices, absolutely nobody. So yeah, you might as well keep that in mind and just, you know, periodically check them, see if they're all fine. No blood, no weird eye convulsions or anything. And this, my friends, I guarantee will ensure, or at least a bit, your survival during the zombie outbreak. Sing a few lyrics of a song you like. What? Are you kidding me? I read this. Oh god. There's a fire starting in my heart, reaching a fever pitch, and it's bringing me out the dark. The scars of your love remind me of us. They keep me thinking that we almost had it all. The scars of your love, they leave me breathless. I can't help feeling we could have had it all. Rolling in the deep, you had my heart inside your hands, and you played it to the beat. And it's not happening again. Alright, so next question. Ho ho. And this is actually one of my favorite questions. By the Lady Trickster. If you could be me, why? Besides being awesome, of course, she says. Well, if I could be the Lady Trickster, well, you know, awesomeness, it works kind of like a magnet. Like, when you're awesome, it's like other awesome people, they kind of like gravitate toward each other. So, I guess like the first, that would be like the real advantage of being the Lady Trickster. I could meet like so many awesome people just by standing and being awesome. Oh wait, and also, you're Australian, so I'm sure that something I would have done as a kid would be jumping to one of those belly bags that the kangaroos have. That could have been so much fun. As a kid, obviously, now I can't do it. Next question from Kisius SK. If you think AC4 is gonna be better than AC3, what is the main reason? Well, first, although you said it for me, I do think AC4 is gonna be better than AC3, just because of some, I mean, obvious changes, like that now ground finishes in a different button, so it won't mess with your kills and stuns. But actually, I think that the main factor that will make whether Assassin's Creed 4 is better or worse than AC3 is if it will be glitchy or not. And unfortunately, we cannot know that just yet. But I certainly hope that it won't be. Durandal Sor asked, who teach you to play Assassin's Creed? Who inspired your playstyle? Well, actually nobody taught me to play Assassin's Creed. I just kind of played on my own. Though, as for who inspired my style, well, I am, as I said kind of before, I am a Devil May Cry player. And one of the main concepts of Devil May Cry is fighting with style. Well, in the case of Devil May Cry, it is fighting. But I kind of always stay with that concept, and I just kind of want to be fancy in whatever I do. So I kind of took that into Assassin's Creed, and I just, you know, found ways to make my gameplay interesting and to find it rewarding for myself. And some people who I kind of looked up to from my younger days as an Assassin's Creed player are AV Santos and Magnitude X. Mostly because they were commentators, and I really liked Santos' playstyle. And currently I'm in Outcast Templar, so I actually got to meet him. Back then I just kinda looked upon him as somebody who I would like to meet, but I never really had an idea that I would actually meet him, and I did. Okay, so the next set of questions are from Killed It Thrice. Her first question is, where do you learn to type so fast? And yeah, she knows that because she has talked to me on Skype and other things. Well, actually, it's a little story. Well, I just got a job. I'm a software developer. And on my second job, I worked as a team with other people. So sometimes it will be somebody else typing, and sometimes it will be me programming. And I just felt kind of embarrassed that I was the slowest of the group. So I kind of, you know, said to myself that I wanted to be faster. So I started practicing 2 hours a day, and like in about 2 months, I learned to type. I was the fastest in the group. If the world ended, how would you want it to end? Really? Come on, kid. End of the world questions? Okay, well, actually I wouldn't want it to end, but okay, if it ended, I don't know. If it ended, I don't know, something quick and painless. I certainly wouldn't choose end of the world with zombies. As much fun as that may sound for some people, it's gonna be a lot of time running. No, sorry. Something maybe like, I don't know, an internal earth explosion and we just die immediately as it explodes and we don't feel any pain at all. That will be reasonable. Italian food or Mexican? Well, that wouldn't be fair. I haven't just tasted Mexican food. I have tasted Italian, and I can say it's pretty good, but I don't know, maybe, yeah, I'll go with Italian for the time being. How tall are you? Simple question. 6 inches and 3, what? Wait, the other way around. 6'3". And the final question from Kid. Why the fudge won't you let me win one day? That question sounds kind of similar to someone else's, but basically it's the same answer, and it's that you just don't play enough with me, Kid. It's not that I don't let you win, you're just not trying enough times. I'm pretty sure that if you tried more, you will probably beat me. Believe me, everybody who plays me for a while beats me. Samage Power says, what do your family and friends think about you making videos on YouTube? Well, to be honest, my family, I mean, they do know that I do YouTube videos, but they're mostly indifferent to it. I mean, they just look at like anything else that I did. It's not like they look up to it or that they look down on it. They just know that I do it, pretty much. Can you do tutorials to get better at multiplayer? I already have. You should try, well, I will do more, but you should try checking the training that I have done with Friendly Gamer. And also there's like tip of the day things on some of my videos. I actually have stopped doing that mostly because there's no more tips, I guess. Maybe there's a little more, but there's not much. But yeah, I have already done some of that. And yes, I think I will keep doing those in the future as well. Swaggy Wind asked, how do you come up with NovaMage? Well, I already explained that, so yeah, just gonna skip to the next question, which is, name your two favorite Assassin's Creed multiplayer characters in each of the games. Well, from Brotherhood, my two favorite characters are the Harlequin and the Damarosa. Oh my gosh, she's so hot. From Revelations, my favorites are the Corsair and I'm quite like deciding here. I guess I will go with the Trickster. Yeah, definitely the Trickster. In fact, if you check my old videos, you'll see that from day one I am playing with the Trickster. So yeah. And from Assassin's Creed 3, well, unquestionably, there's the red coat, and there's kind of like a tie between the Huntsman and the Sharpshooter, which just by looking at my videos, you can see those are the characters I normally use. Who are the players that you have the most problems in Wanted and Deathmatch? Well, usually, I have problems with those players that are good, meaning that they really have lots of experience playing this game, but also, they play with everything they've got, like with all the abilities and everything. They're used to playing with everything. They're like, nothing is true, everything is permitted. Do you ever come to Finland? Well, I'm sorry, I wish I could, but yeah, I don't quite have the money. I really wish one day I had the kind of money to travel to many places in the world, and who knows. Okay, so next up is our lovely Rude Onion, and also known as COVID Lack. Yeah, what a weird name. And her first question is, what's better, root beer or Pepsi? To be honest, neither. If you were to win the $70 million lottery tomorrow, how would you send it to me? Via check or PayPal? Well, first of all, I don't think you can transfer that kind of amount of money by those two ways. So no, I will actually go in person to deliver it to you. Sure. Well, the next question comes from the games critic via Twitter, and he said, what one unannounced feature would you like to see in Assassin's Creed 4? Actually, I'm kind of happy with what I have seen already about Assassin's Creed 4, but the one thing I really want in the game is it to not be glitchy. I mean, that's just for a start. And after that, if Artifact Assault comes back, I will be pretty happy with that, because from the past two games, they have been eliminating modes in each game, and I think that probably Domination isn't gonna make it back, but I surely wish that Artifact Assault did, because it is the only team mode that I actually like. Born Gamer asked, what is your deepest and darkest secret? Let me say, it is my credit card number. And I have already told you, haven't I? Okay, And the final question.
Yes, we made it. We made it to the final question.
And the final question comes from AlexUtsa123. And she says, why are you such a Nova? That's actually a really clever question, you know? It has like a hidden message underneath. Because I love being Nova. I mean, it is just awesome. Well, I guess that's it. We're done with the questions. But I'm actually really thankful for everybody who asked a question. And to all of you for, you know, coming back, keeping up with my content and, you know, commenting, liking, everything. You guys are awesome. And as always, if you like, hit the like button, and I'll see you next time. Peace!
Honorable death. You have finished first.
And Nova Star always wins every game. Every game I've played with him, he's won.